И now I'd like to invite to talk our distinguished guest from Poland, professor of sociology Henryk Domański, who will be talking on interrelationship between social stratification and eating patterns on material of Poland.
Thank you. I will be very concrete. I will refer to empirical results of my research. The problem concerns two questions: whether social stratification of eating really exists in Poland. I believe that yes. Maybe problem is not original, because stratification of eating was researched in some countries, although it is underdeveloped way of empirical finding. But in Polish case it is important, because our research made on national sample was first one on this question. This is the first thing. The second thing is to determine where does this stratification of eating comes from, which means that I will focus on reasons, causes, maybe relationships between stratification of eating and attributes of individuals, attributes of social position. Before I present analysis, maybe some theoretical questions to be determined. It is important that we realize what means stratification of eating or stratification of lifestyle, because I consider stratification of eating as one of the aspects of more general question of lifestyle. Following Pierre Bourdieu, I am inclined to believe that stratification of lifestyle follows class structure, which means that what we are doing, how we participate in culture, depends on our class positions. By class positions I mean mainly occupational roles or market positions, something connected with economic attributes. As you remember, as you agree, Bourdieu follows in this case Marxist theory, saying that class structure is developed, is underpinned by economic circumstances. So lifestyle results from class position, and one of the aspects of lifestyle, stratification of lifestyle, is patterns of eating. What people eat, with whom, what they are doing at the time, and so. The next thing concerns eating itself. How to locate eating, patterns of eating, in social structure. I would follow in this respect rather known theory of, maybe not theory, but analytical schema by Otis Dudley Duncan, who divided attributes of social position, when we are looking at this from the point of view of individual biography, career, as consisting of three links. The first link consists, are resources, investments, inputs, maybe social origin, but first of all, educational level. These are resources that are needed, that we, having these resources, we enter social position. This is the second link. So first one, resources. Next, we are going with this to social positions, occupational roles or class roles. And the third link, according to Duncan, is consists of rewards, benefits, privileges or disadvantages, and so. And one could ask how we define eating in these three links in this triad. According to my opinion, eating refers first of all to resources, some resources that are important, because if somebody knows, for example, my supervisor, if he knows that I'm going to attractive luxury restaurant and I'm eating refined dishes, it may be important in, for example, in my career from some point of view, because it advances, it raises my esteem, my prestige, and so on. So it is resource. Whether it is social position, no. Eating, it is behavior, it is style, it is something which is not related to what we are doing. It is rather consequence. So I would regard eating as, on the one hand, resource, on the other hand, something that correlates with social positions, like recreation, sport events, reading literature, watching TV, or something like this. Resource on the one hand, on the other hand, rewards. Next theoretical question, why it is important? In my opinion, it is important to research for two reasons. First is that Eastern Europe, not Poland only, but I believe that also Ukraine as well, were affected by inflow of different cultures, especially Western-like cultures from 26 years. In case of Poland, for example, eating or cooking or all things that are related to going to restaurants, preparing eating became very popular in media, in TV shows, many programs related to eating. This is the first thing, affection by Western-like culture, inflow to Eastern Europe of this. Second one is, at least in Poland, is it increasing in standard of life. Income, average incomes, real incomes increased. So if people earn much more than before, they can afford to buy many things, various dishes, which were not available under communist system, evidently. And next thing, structural underpinning is related that people in Poland and in Ukraine are going abroad, and we have a much more opportunity to know new things, to learn how to eat, not how to eat maybe, but what to eat, some things which not available. I was not familiar with many items of eating, for example, and I get this knowledge last years. This is the first thing why it is important. Second thing concerns theory. Theory saying about detachment of cultural participation from class stratification. It is very popular thesis, started in the 50s of the last century, which is saying that we are much more diversified, much more individualistic, that there is something like called too. Gastronomy, which means that we have such many offers that people do not know which of them choose. Gastronomy means that we do not we lost criteria of choosing many things. Gastronomy, individualism, informalization means that, for example, eating does not take place in the family but outside, in work, for example, or in schools. So there are many arguments, maybe convincing, maybe logical, saying that cultural participation, cultural differentiation detaches from social stratification. But as far as I know, empirical results on relationship between cultural participation and social stratification, I do not find any saying that in fact such detachment exists. And what I will show you in case of Poland also rather confirms this thesis about close relationship between cultural participation residing in eating patterns to class structure. This is what I referred to theoretical background of my research. Research was carried out in 2013 in Poland on national sample. I'm going to methodology, national sample. It is interesting maybe to know that we divided this survey into two parts, just to control for seasonal changes in eating. one half of this research was carried out in May and June 2014, and the next one in the autumn. Of course, questionnaire was repeated. Maybe also interesting could be that questionnaire concerned mostly, it included questions concerning what did you eat? This was a question asked by interviewer. What did you eat last day? It was carried out, for example, on Friday, on Thursday. Interviewer approached respondent. What did you eat last day? And respondent said about everything what he experienced from waking up until going back, everything. So it is rather, it seems to be rather a reliable measurement of eating, focusing on behaviors, maybe more on behaviors than on values and orientations. But we also included question concerning very general questions, and this is first question that I'm going to. Namely, we included a question saying, here is respondent were presented with show card. Here you have a list of various dishes, various food. Please say whether you have tried some of them during your life. So it was yes, no. And this table shows results across basic occupational categories or across categories that I would refer to social classes. If everybody that carried out empirical research and used empirical data know that these six classes are so-called EGP classes following construction by John Goldthorpe and Robert Erickson. It is rather well-known analytical schema. So these six classes, in my opinion, are rather good reflection of social stratification in Poland. And in rows you have percentages of people saying, yes, I did, I have tried this in my life. Unfortunately, this table is divided into two because it is very long. So I will go across all items, across all dishes, but the general, it is interesting whether you know these names, because for example, when we prepared questionnaire, I was not familiar with many of them, and my younger colleagues who participated in research devised these names. I know them in Polish, but not in English, not necessarily, not all at least. But anyway, you see, there are two regularities because some of these items are extremely popular in Poland, are very common. So if they are very common and for example experience for 90% of people, they cannot be differentiated by class structure. It relates only to some dishes which are rather exotic, refined, luxury, maybe dietitian, maybe nutritionism, something that can be attributed to higher position, to membership in upper middle class that develops in Poland. Upper middle class, or in Polish, that may be referred to new intelligentsia. New intelligentsia is more likely to experience such exotic luxury, rather esteemed, prestigious dishes. And if you see this, you see this pattern. For example, in case of. Further, Carpaccio, for example, Carpaccio, baklava, cholent, which in Polish means cholent, Jewish dish, artichokes, shrimps, couscous, tiramisu, tortilla, and so on. You see that there is a close pattern that likelihood for intelligentsia is the highest to participate in this, and in case of lower classes, the lowest, relatively the lowest. You see evident hierarchy, evident gradient in participation in such cases, which may be regarded, as showing close correspondence between class stratification and choosing some rather esteemed or prestigious kind of foods. In the pre-ultimate column, you have average percentage, the percentage of people in total population, the total number of respondents having access to this, experiencing these items. I will go from time to time through these three parts. And in the last column, you have some measure of correlation between division into these six classes and saying that, yes, I experience such dishes. The higher value of this last column, the higher correlation. Relatively low, this is relatively low, but in some cases it is quite good. For example, in case of artichokes, 6.5. I remind you maybe that this kind of this measure ranges from 0 to 100. So it is relatively low, but anyway, significant and important. Couscous also relatively well correlates, 12.0. You see this in the last. You see this in the last column. Couscous. This is the last column that I am saying about. Tiramisu is also stratified, not bad. The correlation is relatively high. The same is true in case of tortilla, 10.7. This is eta square that may be referred to correlation. Olives, not bad. Okay, this is the first thing that can confirm this thesis that in fact culinary practices or consumption or what we are eating refers to social stratification. Maybe to show it in a more synthetic way, I constructed summary measure of participation in eating. Namely, I took out of this more than 30 items, I took out 20 items, limiting them to refined, luxury, prestigious, esteemed food. So I simply added respondents yes to this question. So this measure ranges between 0 and 20. 0 and 20, the Cronbach alpha, which is a measure of reliability in this case between these 20 items, is relatively high. It is about 0.44 or something, 0.84. So it is rather big. Says that this construction is maybe reliable measure of participation in prestigious and esteemed food. Then I regressed this scale on several sociological, socio-economic, socio-cultural and metric variables, such variables that can explain this. Using such independent variables, which are listed below. Class position of respondents divided into the six categories. Father's class position defined in the same way. Spouse's class position, I defined it also in terms of six classes. Some measures of social capital, educational level, age, place of residence, size of place of residence, and gender. The basic descriptive features, what we have on vertical axis refers to points on these summary measures, ranging, I remind you, from 0 to 20. This description, this is relationship between this synthetic measure and index of eating with class positions. You see gradient, very clear gradient. The highest participation in all these items have intelligentsia, professionals and managers. It declines, and relatively the lowest degree of participation in these are farmers. So we see on this example that social stratification in cultural participation in this case exists. The same is true in effect of father's class position. The pattern is the same. People originating in intelligentsia among professional and managers had higher access to these items. They choose them most frequently, and so farmers are on the lowest position. Spouses, social position. The same. Social stratification works. People having spouse, husband or wife, from intelligentsia have the highest likelihood of participating in this luxury, prestigious, esteemed food. Then I constructed two measures of social capital. People were asked this question: Do you know personally someone who could help you, if need be, in the following matters? And the list of these matters followed, concerning lending money, handling with various things, looking for apartment, helping for small jobs, and so. So this scale of social network or social capital was constructed out of six items. I constructed from this quantitative scale, and the same scale was constructed for family networks, including the same questions. And we see correlation between network, family network, which means relatives helping respondent to all these things, and correlations between this scale and index of eating. Also, we have very gradient relationship, which means that the higher network of such social support, the higher probability that somebody ate in his life luxury foods, dishes, esteemed dishes. And the same pattern reveals in case of another indicator of social capital, in case of having help from friends. Very clear. Level of education. Also, the higher education, the higher likelihood that you participate in esteemed and luxury food. Nothing changes. Gender, interesting, maybe not so differentiating, but anyway, interesting that female are more heavily engaged in eating such prestigious, esteemed food as compared to male representatives of the Polish population. But I believe that it can reveal also in Ukraine if you carried out such research. Age is typically curvilinear pattern, curvilinear in that the categories, the cohorts located in the people of the middle age are mostly involved in using such luxury foods, such refined foods, such esteemed food, not younger people, and the list is that of age categories. Finally, I really regressed this index of eating on place of residence, still one. People living in the higher areas, in metropolitan areas, in Warsaw, for example, have much more experience with this kind of eating. Also some stratification, but related to size of place of residence. These are results of regression. First, values in this column show you explanatory power of variables, individual variables, independent variables that I included in regression. There are more or less of the same degree. It is, of course, social class of respondent, division into these six categories, has the highest impact. You see 6.2 of variation in this summary index is explained by six EGP categories in case of respondents, but it is also, you see, significant effect of father's class position. It is not bad, it is relatively high. And the same is true in case of effect of class position of spouse. It explains relatively a lot. And these two social capital measures contribute as well. I would especially emphasize relatively high value of R square of explanatory power of all variables that I included in this measure in a regression equation. Almost 43%, it is very good, I think, very good result. When we come to metric coefficients, these are metric coefficients. This is the same in the former table, but distinguished into more detailed relationship. You see also some gradient, evident gradient, in that Polish intelligentsia has the highest likelihood of accessing, availability of this kind of food included in this summary measure, and it decreases according to the class value. The highest access, net effect of net relationship with this measure, the highest is among non-skilled manuals in this case, non-skilled workers. The same gradient comes through, holds true in case of effect of father's class position. So we see that something related to social origin that may be attributed to effect of socialization, I think, effect of socialization during bringing up in youth and going to the school has important effect on what is going on afterwards in case of culinary practices. Then we have almost the same effect of spouses, class position, the same gradient. Class stratification is confirmed also in this case. In case of effects of two indexes of social network, we have parameters, but they are statistically significant, not shown here. In case of place of residence, also we have curvilinear relationship, maybe less important in this case. And in case of age, people, the cohort 35-44 are mostly involved in participation in refined luxury lifestyle. Coming to conclusion. First conclusion is that maybe it was not shown here, but first conclusion that I would like to remember is that Polish society in eating is rather traditional. Most of people uses such dishes, such food that were used in the communist system, like for example potato or milk or eggs, all these things that did not change. This is general conclusion concerning Polish population in overall. Second conclusion is saying about thesis about of dying of classes. It doesn't confirm. You see that class stratification has a significant and traditional impact on cultural participation. It confirms results obtained also in other countries. And maybe the last thing is that we see here not only effect of class stratification, but important aspect of this class stratification, namely effect of social origin, measured in terms of father's category. It is very important that what we are using to participate, our cultural activity must be related, that will be related to who our parents were, whether they belong to intelligentsia, working class, or farmer class. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you.